This is the image of the new father used by the advertising industry in the 90s to sell the modern family lifestyle. It reflects a major shift in men's attitude towards their children in the last 50 years and a sea change in the kind of dad they aspire to be. The physical and emotional intimacy between father and child has never been more intense.
Suddenly, you're in there, right in the middle, with someone that you just love to bits. We just had a huge amount of fun together, this little person who is just evolving before my eyes. And I was with her sort of all day long, every day.
Never had expectations of the good father been so high. But at the same time, never had dads felt so vulnerable, so powerless, and so excluded from family life. As divorce spiraled, the legal system marginalized fathers, making it difficult for them to stay close to their children. They became lost in a labyrinth of bureaucracy and court orders. Some took to the streets, bewildered by changes that seemed to be making them redundant.
What sort of person is going to say, actually, you know what, we don't need fathers? What sort of person is going to say, well, you know, we're going to put you through 8 years or 10 years, going through the family justice system? Two parents are better than one. Surely, to God, that's what we believe in as a country. Surely that's what's best for children.
But when families split up, it was still the mother rather than the father who was assumed to be the natural and best parent.
Fatherhood is not really looked upon with the same sort of strength as motherhood. This weird concept that somehow mothers are closer to their children. It's something that I think has become a self-fulfilling prophecy, where we've said it so often that we not only believe it, we now enact it, and we now have a society where it's a norm.
In almost every home in Britain, the relationship between the modern father and his children was being redefined. 50 years of sexual liberation and feminism had changed the rules. The hands-on modern dad was very different to the traditional father figure of the past. He was more intimate, yet more insecure. This is the story of the difficult birth of the new father. A new generation of fathers whose marriages split up were now demanding shared parenting rights. This was rarely achieved because the courts preferred the children to live with one of the parents, usually the mother. The change from hands-on father with a day-to-day caring role to weekend dad was hugely painful. Don't be scared. Matt O'Connor was a loving dad with two young sons. When his marriage broke up, he saw how the legal system turned partners against each other, aggravating every grievance and denying him his role as a loving father.
I went from seeing my children every day to seeing them in a contact centre for what a judge described as a cooling off period, which was profoundly distressing, not just for me, I think for the kids, because you're at home 1 minute and you're sitting in front of the TV and you're watching bloody Jar Jar Binks and Star Wars and stuff, and next minute you're in this cold, inhospitable landscape of formica chairs that are broken and toys that are broken, being watched by sort of three people sitting at a table. And a Kafka's court welfare officer came up to me when I was with the kids, so I hadn't seen for a period of time, and then started asking me questions in front of the children. It's like, I've not seen my children. Yeah. So you struggle to get by.
Matt abandoned the court system and came to a friendly arrangement with his ex-wife so he could have regular access to his children. Then in 2001, Matt formed Fathers for Justice to bring the plight of fathers like himself into the public eye. They soon made the headlines with dramatic protests in which divorced dads dressed up as comic book superheroes and scaled famous public buildings.
guys, get your super suits on, right? Down a fancy dress shop, get a ladder, go. And that was it. So when people say, why do you do these things? Why do you subsequently go off and start a campaign? I went off and started a campaign because the law wasn't being enforced, the court orders weren't being enforced. The law is farcical and grotesque and abusive to all the participants who go into the system, including the mums, but most of all children.
Matt O'Connor remarried, had a new son and became stepdad to his second wife's daughter. It was a very modern and happy family. But his commitment to Fathers for Justice remained as strong as ever.
What sort of person is going to say, actually, you know what, we don't need fathers? What sort of person is going to say, well, you know, we're going to put you through 8 years or 10 years of going through the family justice system, bankrupt the family emotionally and economically with no resolution, this fundamentally abusive system? What we're saying is, right, you can't necessarily go back to the traditional nuclear family, but the most important thing is, the maths are simple. Two parents are better than one. And that's what I believe in. Yeah, after separation, or yeah, hopefully if you're together, it's even better, but if it has to be after separation, retain the love and care of both parents, and never, ever hate your ex more than you love your children.
Fathers have come a long way in the last 100 years. Most modern dads want to enjoy an intimate relationship with their children from the beginning. And breaking the bond with their children is something they're less inclined to accept than before. Fathers in history have often been stereotyped as remote, distant, and uncaring figures. But across 100 years of change, encompassing a social and sexual revolution, they've enjoyed much closer and more important relationships with their children than has previously been thought. Those who did have enriched their own lives, on the way, changing attitudes and making new lives possible for their children.